have one farm, and they always to call harmony farm to grow the own fruit and the own vegetable now. They are so very poor family and orphan and homeless. So about this, so I'm so happy can to have them classroom and one office, the other one school with the bedroom and the kitchen. The orphanage open like this to have the children live at the countryside, homeless and orphan. I can choose to come here and to learn English here and Khmer. All the drum like this and all the kids live here and they play the drum. In Khmer they call Cheya. Can play with them something of fundraising in Siem Reap, or also we can to support the community play the drum or at the pagoda, something from a drum. This is a good drum for in Cambodia. This is a solar system for get from the electricity from the sun. We can use it for 3 hours a day. This is a small garden and behind a kitchen, yeah. Kitchen. And like here and compost toilet. This is compost toilet, but we will choose separate. This one, 2 box. And so this box and full. And so we will keep closed. We open over there and to use. Or compost you to the farm, or yeah, use something around it. We keep for 5 months or 6 months and we take compost out. And we put a rice house with the dirt. I grow the, you know, spinach and salad or something around here, but so about this, we grow and we take out already. But we will start again and again, because we always need it every day. Also, we always to help all the time, like here, they can them and to make a food, and so you can take them and to make a soup or yeah, or something to make a food for the children here. In the morning we have a breakfast program and support for 100 kids, and the afternoon we make a dessert and including banana, sweet potato, cassava. In Cambodia it's ngay, but in English, delicious for them and eating every day. When the kids live here, they always go to the farm and to help and grow the vegetable, and also the afternoon, they play volleyball for exercise.
This is our farm that we call Harmony Farms, and yeah, we have many projects. So at the moment we have corn, we have bell, and we have fruit trees, we have chicken yards, we make compost and compost pond, and we have a vegetable garden. So this is permaculture that we're thinking about environment. We need to do something mimic natural.
We hope to eventually be able to provide all our own food and also a place for training in permaculture.
We have the teacher from USA. Yeah, his name Rico.
Mr. Han is training to become a permaculture teacher. So far he's completed the permaculture design course, and he's helped our teacher Rico Zook take other courses. He's been his assistant.
Permaculture so is about the flow of the natural flow of human, and many flow that repeat through the system. It make a pattern. So pattern is the kinds of idea that we need to think in for follow it to build our farm or build something by natural.
He hopes to continue his education and then become a teacher here, and be able to take training courses here, and then which will then fund our farm.
Many people come from other organizations and the people from the area to join with us and study about one week about permaculture.
Trying to make income generation from the farm and with everything we do incorporate it with the children and learning.
So the people just thinking that permaculture is very strange new for them. So they are very lucky, the same is, yeah.
In the village where we live at the moment, it's very small and there's a lot of children, so everyone likes to come here because there's a lot more sort of freedom and open space. It's yeah, and it's a lot healthier environment for the kids here.
It grows very fast, so we can eat a lot. So we can sell it to the people in the area too.
Mr. Han would teach them different gardening techniques with mulching and IMOs, indigenous microorganisms, and weeding and composting, things like this.
This is compost pile that we did about 1 month ago. And in compost pile, we have carbon and nitrogen. We make step by step.
At the moment, we're planning to build a house. We want to build the house out of mud bricks. So we've been doing experiments on mud bricks and mud walls using straw and cow manure. These are all traditional techniques that we're getting the old men in the area are teaching us about.
We want to make a mud brick to build a house. So we don't want to buy the brick from the market. We want to make old.
So this test is clay, cow manure, and rice husk. This is called experimenting. So this would be a very good mix for us to use because rice husk is really easy to get, easier to get than straw. So hopefully this works.
Khmer farm have the clay for fixing technical
display and for training older student. And this one, and for training cattle, and including the sewing machine, and motor clinic, teaching and they learn sewing a clothes and you know, and school uniform, and pen or something, a bag or something about it, so they can sell.
One of the aims is to be able to become independent of foreign sponsorship, and so in order to do that we need to build everything to be self-sustainable. So for the training centre, you know, funds from you know, the hair cutting and motor mechanics go back into the centre and back into the training of the students.
It's a good play for the people thinking about mimic nature, about permaculture that we never had before in Cambodia. So now we just have, like, the first time that we know about permaculture. So we need the people in Cambodia to know about permaculture for half our country.
We'd love for this place to become, you know, a model for local people. We get a lot of local people coming and seeing what we're doing.
Don't kill people, don't kill the soil, don't kill natural. So permaculture are very important for all the world. If the people in the world know all about permaculture, I hope that maybe 5 years more, the world, maybe it gets better. Everything's life good. That we care for us and care for people.
This is a place for long term.